When you ask people what they think about parking in Brighton, you'll get something along these lines.
Very difficult.
Yeah, it's very difficult, very expensive.
Parking is fairly horrendous. I don't come here to park. I park in Shoreham and get the train in because it's just a lot cheaper.
Parking in Brighton is really difficult. Quite often park outside, get the bus in. Very expensive.
So when the council removes on-street parking and tells residents they have to pay with their phones at a cost, you'd expect some uproar.
There's a number of issues. One, will everybody get real connectivity so they can actually use the phone? And secondly, with the additional charge, that's another revenue stream for Brighton Council.
And think about the older generation who may not be happy with dealing with it in that way, so it will keep people out of Brighton.
Yeah, it's just an extra cost, and it's all the hidden costs these days. You know, it just goes on and on.
It's quite expensive enough as it is. Another 10p on top just to be able to have the facility to park. No, it's not fair.
At the moment, the process to remove traditional pay and display machines like this one is moving forward. But for those motorists who are having to pay on their phone, they're forced to pay an extra 10 pence service charge. And some believe that charge is unfair for motorists. Councillor Tony Janio is calling for a revoke on the surcharge, which is currently used to pay for the processing of card payments and development of new features. Around half the meters in the city are being removed by next year, bringing the total number of pay and display machines down to 600, saving the local authority £250,000 a year. In a statement, Brighton and Hove City Council said, "All towns and cities are unique and have different pricing structures for parking, which work for them. Parking is integral to our sustainable transport policy, which seeks to reduce congestion and offer practical alternatives to the car." This is James Dunham for Latest TV News.